Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be doing what you really need to hear right now. So please choose group 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5. Take a deep breath. And let's get started. So starting off with group number 1. Hi group 1, so let's see what you guys got for what you really need to hear right now. So apologies for any background noise, there's some work going on outside. So let's get started. We have manifestation, epidote. So let me just move my crystals over here and then we'll put that one up there. Okay, so this is the main message you need to hear right now. So we have deception, love yourself first. We also have weight, and we also have new location. Okay, and then we'll look into your tarot. So for the tarot, we have the Magician, the Three of Water, the Sun, and Unity. Sorry, I'm really faffing around with these cards today. Okay, so let's have a little look. So what I can see is you have a lot of good things coming your way, okay? So you've been through quite a lot of deception and a lot of confusion with either a group of people or a certain person. And the message here that they want me to say is to love yourself first. Now is the time to love yourself first and to wait for any new news that needs to come through. So we have the Magician and the Three of Water. This could mean that there is someone in the periphery that you really want to kind of go out with and celebrate with. It can also mean new celebrations coming towards you. So essentially you could be invited to a wedding. You could be invited to a group setting like a party or that sort of thing, or you could just generally be enjoying the next few weeks with your friends. This is timeless, so if you've clicked on this quite a way after I've filmed this video, then that's fine. It's basically timeless, okay? So with Unity, it says traditional viewpoints or methods, spiritual organizations, seek out mentors and like-minded friends. So I definitely feel like there's a sense of coming together with certain people that really kind of help you out. So sometimes it could be just going to someone and asking them for their help, or this could just mean that you're kind of craving that intimacy with a certain person, or you just want to hang out with friends and people who are like-minded like you, basically your soul family, okay? So I feel like you're definitely coming away from deception, you're letting go of toxic friendships, and you're coming away from anything that does not serve you. The universe is telling you to love yourself first and to wait for something new to come in. I feel like there is going to be a new partner coming towards you and they're telling you to wait. Don't kind of go towards anyone that's just there because they're there sort of thing, okay? And we also have the manifestation, and I feel like the colouring is very similar. So I feel like these two are connected with each other. They're kind of, it's kind of saying wait because you are manifesting the right things and the new thing will come towards you when you basically least expect it, okay? And we can see you moving to a new location. This could be you even just traveling. This could mean you are moving into a new home. You could be moving jobs. You could be, I'm getting staying at a friend's house. So that's interesting. So I really like that, okay? So we also have the Sun next to Unity, which feels really good. It says, happy outcome, brilliant new ideas that lead to success. Have confidence in yourself. So there's definitely a new opening coming towards you. You might be feeling a bit stuck, but Archangel Uriel is here to show you that there's new things coming towards you. And there's definitely a new opening. I definitely feel that there's a new opening to do with kind of community and coming together with friends and celebration. There's a celebration of some sort. And because we have the Three of Water, which is the Three of Cups, it just means that there's going to be a lot of good emotions running around. So yeah, so I feel like that's everything we need to hear. I feel like I need to pull out another one of these. That's what I'm going to do. This is the Crystal Grid Oracle. I didn't mean to like shuffle that in. This is the Crystal Grid Oracle that I'm using today. I recently just got this. I'm so happy with it. I'm obsessed. So let's see. What else does group number 1 need to know, please? Thank you. You got courage. So now is the time to be courageous. This could mean that you need to step into a new setting. This could mean like starting a new job, and underneath we have heart protection. So maybe you actually need to communicate to somebody something that you feel is affecting you. like there's something you need to say, but you just can't say it yet. You need the courage to say it, or you're having the courage to wait while this something is manifesting. So having the courage to get through a certain situation while something is manifesting, because maybe it's taking a little bit longer than what you want, and it's taking courage to kind of go through it. You could also be going through a death and rebirth process, meaning where you need to basically kind of wait out the storm and kind of get through the storm and be courageous in this time. Okay, so the colors green and red are really, really prominent, so you could also have an earth or a fire sign around you. So thank you for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up, subscribe down below. Also, I do private readings, all the information is down below and on the screen here of how to contact me. If you'd like to, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for being here, and I'll speak to you very soon. Bye. Hello, group number two. Thank you so much for being here. Today we have your crystal, which is a rose quartz. And let's see what you've got for what's coming towards you and what you need to know right now. So we have peace, spirit guides, and soul healing. This is really, really nice. I can see you going through quite an intense transformation at the moment and having to create peace in your life. I think also this will create peace in your life after you've gone through this transformation. I feel like you're definitely going through a really big soul healing. I feel like you could recently have got into spirituality, or you're just on a journey of kind of your soul being uplifted from the 3D to the 5D, and it's becoming quite intense. So make sure to keep resting, keep hydrated, and also to meditate, and maybe use some crystal healing. So actually put all the different crystals on each part of your chakra, and just to kind of balance yourself out. Okay, so make sure to give yourself lots of rest. So we have engagement and healing family issues in the love department. And then we also have set your sights higher, romantic partner. And in the tarot we have awakening, the star, and king of fire. Okay, so you could have a fire sign around you who could actually be creating this soul healing, but I genuinely feel like you will have a romantic partner around you, or there's somebody who's actually interested in you. You might not see this yet because I feel like this might be in the 5D, and hence why they could be like coming towards you, because like hence why we have this soul healing, because you could be connecting them on a soul level and it could actually be making you feel like bleh, really crappy. This card is really calling out to me. We have a three of water. This was what we got for group one, but I felt the need to just kind of grab it. This is to do with communing with other people, like being together with other people and having a celebration with people. So that could also mean that you are gonna meet this person in a setting with lots of people, or when you're out with friends. Okay, so we have a definite awakening here. We have, I love how we have soul healing and we also have awakening. This is Archangel Gabriel. It says, look at things from a different perspective. A temporary standstill is important to be yourself. So you could be having a little bit of an identity crisis at the moment. It sounds really dramatic, but I do feel like you are going through quite a dramatic time. You are going through a time where you are going to be awakening into your true self. And you may think, oh, well, I'm already my true self. But this is kind of on a massive spiritual level. So it's almost like you've gone through so much trauma and things in the past. It's like now it's really time to get your wings open and kind of see what's out there. Set your sights higher. We have increased your standards and expect more for yourself. Don't settle. So when it comes to a romantic partner, don't settle for anything that isn't good enough for you, because if you're going through a transformational period, it's going to be quite a sensitive time for you and you're going to be tempted. I mean, this is normally a thing where you, people are tempted to go towards something that's familiar and to go back into family past issues. Okay, so make sure to kind of move through this uncomfortableness and kind of try and get as much peace as possible in this situation. Sometimes it takes a long time to figure out what you really need, but just kind of do things that make you happy, even if they're just little things or things you think, oh, that won't make me happy. Sometimes it's the little things that really can really help with these sort of things. But I definitely feel like once you've healed these family issues, I definitely see someone coming towards you with an engagement, possibly an actual proposal. Or this could just mean somebody wants to get into a relationship with you and kind of have that higher level of commitment, okay? From like dating to kind of getting into a relationship. So with the King of Fire, it says focus, focus, focus. Communicate with vision and be a leader. Advice from someone creative. So this is the King of Fire. What is that? I think that's the King of Wands. I recently just got this deck. I'm thinking that's the King of Wands. If it's not, than Yas. But I love how we have like the King of Fire and the Star, and they're both like, from what I'm seeing, they're quite similar people. Like, they're both really kind of extravagant, and they look almost like a couple. So I feel like you could be connecting with an Aquarius or a fire sign, someone who's very motivational, but you could just generally be feeling really motivational at the moment. And to keep focusing on the route ahead and to not get sidetracked by, as say, your family issues and things like that, because you are awakening into a really amazing time, and this is really pivotal to keep on track. Also, I feel like your intuition could be getting extremely high, and this could also be affecting your stability and kind of being grounded. So make sure to be grounded, stay optimistic, and happy times are coming towards you. We have someone also you could be connecting with on the 5D, someone who you could be having telepathic communications with, so look out for any signs of repeating numbers, okay? So look out maybe for number 17 and number 12, or maybe 222, 777, that sort of thing. Or just if you feel like you have this situation already, and you and your kind of partner or person you're interested in have a certain number, like a repeating number, look for that as well, and possibly look for songs that come up that maybe to do with the situation, or any sort of guidance that wants to come through will come through, okay? So let's pick another crystal healing card, and let's see what else advice you need to go towards. So we have emotions. So I definitely feel like emotions are going to be running high, and we also have protection. So black tourmaline is really, really good for grounding. I also have this bracelet, which is black onyx, I think. What is it? Pretty sure it's black onyx. But it's very grounding, and I always wear this when I'm doing readings because it helps me ground. So I definitely feel like that's going to be really, really helpful for you, because if your emotions are running high, make sure to ground yourself with crystals. And just kind of try and get in the moment as much as possible. Okay, so thank you so much for watching. If this helped, give it a big thumbs up, comment down below, let me know if this resonated. I love hearing from you guys. Thank you so much for 2,000 subscribers. You guys are absolutely amazing. I love you. And if you'd like to get a private reading with me, all the information is down below, and all the information is on the screen here, and on how to get in contact with me. So don't forget to subscribe, and I'll speak to you very soon. Bye. Hi group number 3, thank you so much for clicking on this video. Let's see what you have. So from the Crystal Grid Oracle, we have self-love, communication, and soul journey, which is so lovely. I love this combination. And then we also have body movement and ready, set, go. And then on the romance oracle, we have romance oracle. In the romance deck, we have this could be the one, let go of control issues and romantic feelings. And in the tarot, we have Knight of Cups, the Star, the King of Cups, the Chariot, and the Six of Cups. So I definitely feel like there's someone coming towards you, like from your past. There's someone coming towards you with an emotional offer. Mm-hmm. And I feel like this is something that you're actually waiting for. This is definitely a time that you are thinking, okay, now's the time that I want to get into a relationship. And I feel like you're fully ready. I feel like this is you. And you are kind of looking into the past and kind of dealing with past issues. But I also feel like this could be someone coming back from the past, like almost coming towards you, and you kind of don't expect it. But you're definitely working on self-love, and you're working on communicating how you really feel. And I feel like this is really, really positive for you. So we have the Star with the Knight of Cups, and I feel like this goes hand in hand together, because I feel like somebody's going to come forward with an emotional offer who's also, like, could also be a soulmate or a twin flame, someone in the ethers. Someone could also be in the 5D going into the 3D and coming towards you, which is really, really nice. You could also be connecting with a Cancerian, Pisces, Scorpio, Aquarius, and that's what I see over there. I don't feel like maybe a fire sign as well. So I feel like you're definitely getting on the road to movement. I feel like you've been stagnant for quite a long time, and I feel like almost, this sounds really bad, but I feel like I get the image of a car moving, and someone, and you, like, got a seatbelt on, taking your seatbelt off, opening the car door while the car's moving and jumping out and just kind of rolling and running away. So I feel like it basically means that you kind of, you're taking off the brakes and you're fully going for it. That's a positive message, by the way, about the car. It just basically means that you're not letting any obstacles, like, kind of come in front of you, and you are letting things go. Now is a perfect moment to dive in and embrace your heart's desire. And I definitely feel like this is what we see here with the King of Cups and the Knight of Cups. and this is definite movement here. So body movement could mean also that you start in an exercise regime. There's a bird outside that's really, really loud. It's really cute. And it basically means that you could be starting to move your body more, as in like you could maybe start a dance class. You could maybe start doing more yoga. I can see a guy pumping like what they call weights. I can see a guy doing weights being quite muscly. So you could actually meet someone at the gym. Or you could meet someone who's quite fit and buff. Or if you're a guy with a girl, it's basically the same thing. Anyone that's kind of fit and healthy. I feel like you are basically working on yourself and creating self-love for yourself as well. So we have 3, 4, and 5, which essentially means you are definitely moving forward. You are like ready, set, go, let's go, go, go. I feel like these pink and blue are really, really nice colors because they're very soft and they're very good for communication and heart-centered communication as well. So I definitely feel like someone on your soul journey is really coming towards you with a certain message, or a certain message about 2 months after this video, I'm hearing. So it won't be two weeks to 2 months after this video, when you've watched it, because this is timeless, when you've watched it, this person I feel like will come towards you because they are being guided by the universe, and this almost looks like a compass. So I definitely feel like they have an inner compass. We all have an inner compass, really, this kind of guides us to where we need to go. But I definitely feel like there's just a certain journey that your person is going to go on. If you're looking for a new partner, they're almost going to flip their life, almost like what you're doing, where you're like enhancing your self-love and bringing that more in. They're almost going to flip and think, oh my god, and then they're going to move on to a new path coming towards you. Okay, I don't feel like they're on their path towards you as well. It's going to be a person that has romantic feelings for you, or you have romantic feelings for them. This could be the one. I definitely feel like there's going to be some really good communication towards you two, or you and a friend, or you and a group of people, because I feel like you are beginning to let go of control issues. They could also be letting go of their control issues. If this is something that has kind of controlled your life, then this is definitely something that that is going to be starting to let go of, and the angels and guides are looking over you and the person you're interested in as well, and helping you to come together. Okay, obviously if you are in a relationship, essentially your angels and guides are helping you in your soul journey, helping you to get through any tough times. Also remember to communicate and set healthy boundaries in certain situations. Okay, so I also feel like I don't know why, but I'm really, yeah, that's so funny, I'm really connected to this tail on this mermaid. And I just said, didn't I, about the blue and the pink, and this tail is blue and pink. So I definitely feel like those colors are either like your favorite colors, or they're just really good for kind of helping emotions to flow. So maybe get yourself maybe like it says a cobalto calcite, and these crystals I really cannot pronounce, so I'm just gonna hold them up to the camera, and if you guys want to have a look into them, then you can. And also possibly rose quartz, I'm thinking, as well, for the heart chakra. And any blue crystals are really good. So thank you guys so much for watching and clicking on this video. I appreciate you so much. Thank you so much for 2,000 subscribers. You guys are absolutely amazing. Feel free to subscribe, give me a thumbs up, comment down below if this resonated. Also, if you would like a private reading with me, all the information is down below. And to connect with me, all the information is on the screen here. And I'll speak to you very, very soon. Also, don't forget to subscribe if I didn't say that already. I probably did. Okay. Bye. Bye, guys. Hello, group number 4. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. We have the gorgeous amethyst here. It has a little silver angel underneath. So let's see what you guys got for what you really need to know right now. So we have inspiration. This card is so pretty. Look at all those colours. Ugh, so pretty. And then we also have explore your options and trust your intuition. Okay. And then from the romance angel deck, we have let your friends help you and heart-to-heart conversations. And then from the tarot, I pulled quite a few cards for you. We have the Magician, Knight of Wands, Ace of Swords, Queen of Cups, Seven of Pentacles, Four of Pentacles, the Devil, and the Wheel of Fortune. Ooh, we got a lot of information going on here. Okay, so I love all the cards we've got. They're all really, really strong cards. I definitely feel like you are moving into a new kind of situation. Things are starting to move and you're really starting to manifest things. Your intuition is becoming really, really high and you're starting to get quite a few downloads. I feel like you're getting quite a few synchronicities as well. I feel like there's an option that you need to figure out whether you want to take it or not, but trust your intuition with this situation and everything will be okay. So explore your options also. It says it's time to look for other possibilities. It's a good time to make changes. So you could be looking into a new job. You could be figuring out what job you want to do and to figuring out if it's the right thing for you to do. I feel like going for a job or whatever this option is, do what makes you feel happy and anything that is emotionally fulfilling for you, okay? Definitely trust your intuition. I feel like you've been trusting your intuition on a certain situation and your intuition is quite high in this certain situation. So if you feel like, oh, I should ignore it, definitely this is a sign where you should really trust what your intuition is saying, okay? So with this inspiration card, I definitely feel like you're going to get quite a lot of different you're going to explore different territory. I think in the next few weeks something's going to come up that's really going to surprise you. You could also get some information from a certain person, a message from a certain person, or you could be hanging out with new people, okay? There's definitely a lot of open, expansive energy going on here. I definitely feel like you have worked on your sacral chakra and you're becoming more open to new possibilities. So we have the Knight of Wands and the Magician together. So it basically means that I feel like you're going towards somebody or they're coming towards you who I don't think you're expecting this person to come forward. And it's going to be a really stable offer. It's going to be quite a fast offer as well. You could also be having a new job offer, which is really, really cool. Something also that's going to be really financially stable and emotionally stable. I love that we have the Wheel of Fortune here as well, because I'm kind of seeing that inspiration card as the Wheel of Fortune. So that's really, really good. You have kind of the double cards here. Definitely something you're going to go towards. It's really emotionally fulfilling. I feel like someone's almost going to offer you some sort of offer because they can see how successful you are and how kind of qualified you are for a certain kind of task or job, or even in a relationship. They might think, well, this person's got a lot going for them. They're really like emotionally stable and I really kind of want to go forward with the situation. So with the Seven of Pentacles and the Wheel of Fortune, you are working on a sort of new endeavor. As I say, there's definitely a new start going on. I feel like you are working really hard in starting a new life for yourself. You could be moving house. You could be starting a new relationship. Something is going on here that's really starting to, I'm hearing like a revving of a lawnmower. It's like vroom, 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 and it's like really starting up. So I definitely feel like something is moving now. There's not, something is starting up and moving. There's no kind of, there's no kind of stagnant energy here, which is really, really nice. So we also have the Four of Pentacles with the Devil. I feel like someone you might be connecting with is holding back their feelings, or they are dealing with their addictions. This could also be you as well, but I feel like either one of you is working hard on kind of coping with this certain situation. And because things are moving, I feel like it's starting to be more in the past, but this is going to keep occurring if this is not sorted. I feel like you might be tempted to go back into normal ways of possibly any addictions or anything that's kind of low vibrational energy. So make sure to look at this with self-love and really focus on yourself and to be open, be more open as well to any new possibilities that come forward. I definitely feel like you could have a struggle with exploring new options as to why we have this card as well. So I definitely feel like you could also get new inspiration. You could also be getting quite a few epiphanies. A lot of information in this group, guys. You are a lucky one. You have a good group. So, yeah, not lucky, but you have a good group. So we have let your friends help you and heart-to-heart conversations. So I feel like you could be having even heart-to-heart conversations with your friends. You could be stuck in a situation. I feel like you might be kind of stuck whether to actually have this communication with a certain person. You're like, I don't really want to, or I don't really want to accept help. But make sure to accept help, guys, because I feel like it's going to be really helpful to you and could also just give you a new perspective and give you new inspiration. So thank you so much for watching, guys. If you like this video, don't forget to give a big thumbs up, comment down below if this resonated. I appreciate you so much. Thank you so much for 2,000 subscribers. You guys are absolutely amazing. Don't forget to subscribe down below. Click that red button. Also, if you'd like to get a private reading with me, all my information is down below. You can connect with me through email or my Instagram. You can message me on there. And we can set up a private reading for you. So thank you so much for being here. I appreciate you and I will speak to you very soon. Bye. Hello group number 5, thank you so much for clicking on this video. Let's see what have you got coming towards you, what you need to know. Okay, so we have balance, friendship, and look inside yourself. Gorgeous, that's really, really nice. I love that. And then we also have from the Romance Angel deck, we have religious factors, soulmate, and unrequited love. From the tarot underneath, we have the Page of Pentacles. So this is basically an offer I feel like you don't see coming, and like a new offer from somebody. Could even be someone younger than you, or like could be a work situation or something to do with money, or just somebody who's very financially stable and financially abundant. Or you could be financially abundant as well from this situation and from this opportunity. So we have the World card, we have the Nine of Pentacles, Knight of Pentacles, Four of Swords, Ace of Wands, Nine of Cups, and Two of Swords. Okay, so you're definitely in a restful period at the moment. I feel like you have kind of come out of balance. I feel like you need to go out and have some fun. I feel like things have kind of gotten on top of you quite a lot, and I feel like you're going through quite a transformational period. I feel really heavy and weighed down, and I feel like this is quite a big thing for you. I feel like you're feeling quite like everything's quite intense. So this is really random, but I have these chakra stones and I really keep being drawn to this, which is, I feel like, I think it's the heart chakra because it's green. And I love that we have this, which is green also. So I definitely feel like you need to work on your heart chakra. There could be something, you could have gone through a breakup, or you could have gone through something that really hurt you, and you're kind of building yourself back up again. I feel like this could actually be separation with a soulmate. So I feel like you could actually, it's like you're being forced to look inside yourself and kind of look into like all the little crevices and cracks, if there's anything that needs to be kind of resolved. But overall, you're going to get you're going to get an offering of some sort that's very, very emotionally stable. And it's from somebody who's really kind of thought about their options and have actually like chosen you. I feel like because they're also seeing you as someone who's very patient, someone who has waited a long time for something really good to happen. It's like, okay, the universe is like, they deserve this. Like the watcher of this video deserves this, okay? So we also have the Knight of Pentacles and the Two of Swords. So I feel like you could actually be deciding if you want a job, a certain job. You could be figuring out, okay, what's more important, job, family, okay, how do we weigh out these options? Also, it's like, should I move? I'm getting like someone moving to a different country because of a job, or moving to a certain person, and it's quite a big move, so quite, I think you're just deciding that. Also, I feel like there's quite a lot of money matters in the next few weeks. You're kind of deciding that you want to maybe work for yourself. You could be want to be self-employed. You want to do some more traveling maybe, and maybe save up for traveling, that sort of thing. Also, you could be kind of happily single and think, I just want to travel, you know. So I see travel coming towards you. I see that there could have been an unrequited love situation. You could have kind of offered your love to somebody and they could have been like, no thanks, I don't really want what you're offering. But I feel like you are kind of thinking, I don't really care anymore, I just want to go towards people who are really suited for me. And I definitely feel like there's someone coming towards you, and I feel like this is the Ace of Wands and the Nine of Cups situation, where it's something that's very fulfilling, something that's very emotionally stable for you. And it's definitely, you've waited a long time for this. I feel like you're the sort of person that's who has gone through quite a few different people, but they've not been suitable. They've been like unemotional, and there's always been things in the way. Maybe their religion is different to yours, that sort of thing. You could also be deciding whether you want to be with somebody, because I feel like there could be religious factors involved, where somebody doesn't really believe in what you believe in, or maybe you're kind of scared to show this person off to your family, that sort of thing. But look inside yourself and really think about what you want, and possibly talk to some friends about how you feel about a certain situation, because I feel like I could help. And also just to generally have some fun and enjoy yourself. Okay, so thank you so much for clicking on this video. Thank you so much for being here. If you like this video, don't forget to comment down below, subscribe, give it a big thumbs up if you liked it. And also, if you want a personal reading with me, a private reading, all the information is down below. You can connect with me on email or Instagram. Don't forget to subscribe. The red button is down below. And I'll speak to you very, very soon. Bye.